I'm Kevin Shaw, and you're watching the Watercraft Journal. Today we got our hands on the 2022 Sea-Doo Fish Pro Trophy. We've been waiting to get our hands on this one for a while, and we're really excited to take you guys with us on our day with the trophy. Now, what we've found is that the Sea-Doo Trophy is without a doubt the flagship of personal watercraft fishing. BRP has put so much detail and so much thought into equipping this watercraft that it's at tournament level performance. We're gonna walk you through all the features, all the standard stuff that comes with the trophy, and we'll even show you how it compares to the lesser Sport and the entry-level Scout. Those are three tiers of Fish Pros available through Sea-Doo. So in talking about the Fish Pro, we really need to address personal watercraft fishing as a burgeoning sport. Now, it's nothing new, it's been going on for decades, but we've seen in recent years, as personal watercraft have gotten more sophisticated, that people are really being able to go out and have a far greater experience in using their personal watercraft to fish. Sea-Doo got hip to this and introduced the Fish Pro back in 2019. Since that time, the Sea-Doo Fish Pro has exploded in popularity. And because of that, Sea-Doo decided, you know what? We're going for the fences, and they opened up everything full salvo with the trophy. Now, why is a personal watercraft such an ideal platform for fishing? For us, number one, it's gonna be cost. Now, we like to joke that with a personal watercraft, you could pack your bait, you could pack your rods, and get a full tank of 87 octane for maybe $100 and spend a full day out on the water. That's a far greater savings than filling up the boat and getting all your buddies to go out with you. So number one, it's gotta be cost. Number two is that a personal watercraft simply can go where a boat can't. We show you here that the trophy, we can get deep into the rivers, we can get into the shallows, we simply can go places that a guy with an outboard simply can't go. So that's a really big benefit for a guy who wants to go out, kind of escape, get alone, and really have a very great personal experience that doesn't require them to launch a big boat or have a bunch of friends. You can do this by yourself. Basically, this is the next evolution of kayak fishing, but with an engine. Now in 2019, when Sea-Doo offered the first Fish Pro, they did it with using the same platform that they use for their GTX, their RXT, and even their Wake Pro. It's what they call the ST3 platform. The ST3 platform is very unique, especially when it comes to all the different kinds of three-seaters that are available today. First and foremost, when it came to designing the ST3, stability was number one on that list. They wanted to make sure that you were able to get up, to move around, and be stable and not feel real tippy when you're out in the water. So they have these very giant, big footwells that even me with a size 12 can stomp around and move around the watercraft and not feel like I'm gonna roll over. Number two is with the Ergo Lock seat, you have a nice narrow saddle, you're not feeling real spread out like you're riding a horse. You get in there, you sit in the watercraft, not on top of it. It's very, very comfortable. Number three, and what's a really unique feature for the ST3, is the center storage system. Instead of having to reach over the handlebars and to get into the front of the storage, they put storage right here in the middle. And you've got an incredible 27 gallons of storage that's super accessible. You lean right in and you can reach anything you want out of here. And with the trophy, it even includes this nice divider so you can put drinks, sunscreen, a change of clothes, and anything else that you need inside. It really makes it convenient. So they chose their ST3 as being the ideal platform for the Fish Pro, and we tend to agree. One last unique feature that really makes the ST3 stand out is their Link platform. Their Link platform allows for a lot of modularity when it comes to if I want to bring extra gas, if I want to bring extra storage, if I want to even bring an extra cooler. Now, the Fish Pro is unique because it has this extended deck on the back. This isn't so much an accessory as it is part of the Fish Pro package. Now, this 13.5-gallon cooler can be moved up onto these link attachments, which will show a second set of link attachments on the transom. But we preferred it out here because this allowed us more room to move around with the swivel seat. We're going to show you more about the swivel seat in just a minute. Now, something that was really unique for Sea-Doo was in 2021, they introduced what they called IDF, and that's the Intelligent Debris Free System. What this does is that if you manage to suck up some grass or some weeds or a stick, and you get that up in the intake grate, you don't want to run that through the pump. So what you do is that you stop your engine, you engage IDF. IDF is going to give you prompts on the screen, and it's going to have you throttle to purge the intake grate. Believe it or not, it actually reverses the rotation of the impeller so that it pushes thrust forward and helps clear out the intake grate. When Sea-Doo decided to really up the Fish Pro to the trophy model, they added a ton of features that actually answer a lot of need for fishermen who are using their personal watercraft to go out on the lake or out on the ocean. One of the neat features that a lot of people have overlooked is the Fish Pro anchor. You're able to operate the anchor with just one hand, so while you have your rod in one hand, you can deploy the anchor. Slides right up, and you've got a mesh bag here with all your lead. They even include its own dedicated cleat here on the inside of the footwell, so you can wrap the lead for the anchor around that without having to reach in and grab all your rope or have a big mess on your hands when it comes to deploying the anchor. One of the most unique features that comes standard on the Sea-Doo Fish Pro Trophy is the new dedicated fishing seat. You simply take the back seat off, get it out of the way. You have a new perch for it right here. Pull out your base, locks in. You got your backrest, and what's great is that the backrest actually has its own dedicated spot inside of the center storage. Locks in. And now you've got a new swivel seat. As you sit down, you put your feet up here, you can relax if you're gonna be spending quite a bit of time out fishing behind your trophy. And one of the neat features about this seat is that there is an electric signal that goes into that perch. What that means is that you can't go full throttle riding around with this seat on. They restrict it to a maximum of 18 miles an hour. That is so if you're going from one spot to another, you don't have to take the whole seat down and put it back up again. You can just hop in the driver's seat, take off, find a new spot where the fish are biting, get back in your swivel seat, and off you go. Sea-Doo equips all three of the Fish Pro models, the Scout, the Sport, and the Trophy, with a Garmin fish finder. What makes the Trophy unique is that it's got the big 7-inch screen that's even brighter than the other ones, and it's also a touch screen. So you can toggle through all the pages. Obviously, we're on a sandbar, so it's pretty shallow, but one of the great things also is that any customer who purchases a Fish Pro, they get one free token through Garmin to get a high resolution map of their local area. If you want to explore and get more maps, you're going to have to go to Garmin and open up your package that way. But we can go through all the many pages in full color, high visibility, and of course, give it a twist and it's fully adjustable. You wanna stand up and read it, you wanna sit down, or if you're sitting on the fishing seat, you can move it so that it's easier to read at any point on the watercraft. The Garmin Fish Finder is also paired to a through-hole transducer so that there's no extra holes, there's nothing hanging off the back that can get torn off. This is a far superior setup than a lot of people who either drill a hole through their hull or try to use a transom puck that's hanging off of the back. You don't want anything extra that's gonna get torn off. One last standard feature is that the trophy comes equipped with the BRP tech package. The tech package includes the BRP premium sound system as well as the larger screen. One last great thing about the screen is that it pairs perfectly with the sound system so that you can control your songs, your playlist, even the volume and tracks all through the controls here on your handlebars. Under the seat, there's a few more things that not a lot of people shine a lot of light on, but is worth talking about. Number one, it's running dual batteries. Number two, it's got a larger generator to help keep those batteries fed and to operate all the electronics on the trophy, whether that's the sound system, your Garmin, or even the deck washing pump. Inside, you also have the standard USB port so that you can plug in your phone and keep it charged in your waterproof case. So what makes the trophy the flagship of the Fish Pro lineup? Well, there's a couple things. We have here a Fish Pro Scout. That is the entry level of the three. The Scout is based on the smaller GTI platform. Comes with the naturally aspirated 130 horsepower engine, and it doesn't have all the bells and whistles as you might find on the Sport, which is the middle of the three, and of course the high level trophy. But the Scout itself does come with a 6-inch Garmin, not a touchscreen, but it does have the 6-inch Garmin with the through hull transducer. It does have the 13.5 gallon tank. It does have the same 18.5 gallon fuel tank, so you can ride all day long, especially with that 130 horse engine. You're really gonna have some really good fuel mileage. It also comes with three rod holders. You have the places up front and the cup holder to mount up there. You can also mount them all the way around the tank. With the Sport, it comes with four rod holders, the same tank, same big gas tank, but you have the A1630 that makes 170 horsepower. So between the Sport and the Trophy, what are the differences? They ride on the same ST3 platform. This is the full length platform that Sea-Doo offers, the big three-seater that has the center storage and the waterproof phone case inside. And it does have the same deck extension mounted on the back. Obviously, the Scout doesn't have that. So you do have the extra link mounts that you can put another cooler, you can put an extra gas tank here, you can do a lot of different things. You can even have a dry bag if you're going overnight. So you have these link attachments. You have the flat fishing seat, but the Trophy has the exclusive swivel seat there with the mount and with the backrest in the back. The Trophy and the Sport and the Scout can be accessorized with an additional tank extension, but that is an accessory for all three. It doesn't come standard on them. One last major difference between the Sport and the Trophy is while the Trophy comes equipped with the tech package, that includes the larger screen that syncs with your phone, as well as the premium audio sound system, the Sport is not available with the whole tech package, but you can option it with the BRP premium sound. One of the best features that Sea-Doo included on the Fish Pro are the rod holders and even now the new link cup holder with the front mounts. So you could really equip your Fish Pro however way you want. We put the cup holder on the other side because this one came equipped with the premium audio system with the new tech package. So what truly sets the Sea-Doo Trophy apart from the Sport and the Scout Fish Pros is the new LiveWell tank. Operated through this three position toggle switch, you have on, off, and your timer. Now you can just turn it on and you can hear it already start to spool up. But if you put it on a timer, you can have it on an interval so that it refreshes the water every 3 minutes that's in the tank. So with our switch on, you can see we've got our live well starting to fill up already. It's pumped from a input here on the transom, ran through an electric pump and a filter and fed right into here. But if you don't necessarily need the live well, or if you're cutting up bait or just washing down your ski, you can detach it from the rear and you can literally hose off your cutting board and your footwells, everything you want here. Then when you're done, you simply pull back, reattaches. So ultimately, what is the 2022 Sea-Doo Fish Pro Trophy gonna set you back? Well, the lineup is actually surprisingly well balanced. The Scout starts at $13,800. If you're stepping up to the Sport, you're going up another $2,000 to $15,800. And then if you want the trophy, you're going up another $1,900 to $17,700. It's a really good bargain for everything you're getting. This is easily the most well-equipped fishing personal watercraft available on the market. This is absolutely a groundbreaking machine. We've had a total blast on it. We loved the first Fish Pro, and that everything that Sea-Doo has put into the new trophy just takes it all that much further. I'm Kevin Shaw, and you've been watching the Watercraft Journal. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to give it a like, leave a comment down bottom, and share it with your friends. It's definitely going to help us grow the channel. And if you want more awesome personal watercraft content, definitely go over to www.watercraftjournal, where new articles are published every single day, Monday through Friday, entirely free to you. As for me, I'm going fishing.